Hello friends, as you all know, sudden cardiac arrest can happen anytime in our hospital and we should be very well equipped to deal with such an event. To know what to do with a patient of sudden cardiac arrest is of paramount importance, as Dr. Sameer Patel has already told you about it, but how to document it is also of very paramount importance. So today I am going to put a small video on documentation in sudden cardiac arrest resuscitation.
So friends, my topic is documentation in cardiac arrest resuscitation. As you all know, cardiac arrest is defined as the cessation of cardiac mechanical activity confirmed by the absence of a detectable pulse, unresponsiveness and apnea. Then why this documentation is so important? Because it provides information that guides for the continuous care of patient. If the patient survives this episode, then this information, it guides us for treatment of the patient. Secondly, it identifies the quality issues of hospital. It tells us that the infrastructure wise or equipment wise, if there is any thing lacking in the hospital or some quality has to be improved, that it identifies. Thirdly, it provides data to answer research questions. Whenever we are having any research project, it can provide very nice data. But most important of all, it helps to answer questions raised by family members. There are hordes of family members, they flock around you after this episode. Kya hua, kyun hua, kaise hua, kab hua. By this documentation, you can tell them very categorically and very clearly, itne baje ye hua, itne baje humne ye kiya, phir itne baje humne aisa kiya, waisa kiya. So it really helps a lot and thereby it reduces the risk of medical litigations. So documentation is of paramount importance of this cardiopulmonary resuscitation. So now let's see how can we document how this documentation is done. There are four distinct variables: patient variables, event variables, outcome variables and hospital variables. These are four variables in which we can document the whole event. Out of this, the above three variables are of very great importance. Hospital variables is mainly for academic purpose. Patient variables, we should be recording, documenting the complete biodata of patient, including name, age, gender, race, address, everything. What was the reason of admission? Why was he admitted in our hospital? What was his pre-arrest status? Was he morbid? Was he fully normal, just about to discharge? Was he in ICU? It has to be very clearly mentioned. Location of event, where this event has occurred, whether it was in ward, ICU, lavatory, room, where? That location has to be clearly mentioned. Was there any witness along in front of the patient who has witnessed the whole event? The witness may be the patient's relative or a sister, nurse, or a medical professional over there. And if there was a witness present, then was the event monitored or not monitored? That has to be mentioned. And if at all there was previous same cardiopulmonary arrest history, that has to be documented again in patient variables. Event variables, if you can diagnose VF, VT or non-VF, VT, it has to be mentioned. And whatever interventions you do, ABC, airway, breathing, circulation, defib, drugs, everything has to be very clearly mentioned. But here I like to give emphasis on defibrillation. That you, all of us should be having a defibrillator at our hospital. It is very handy and it has to be there. All cardiologists, they do recommend it mandatorily. So defibrillation has to be done in a case of cardiac arrest. So you need to have a defibrillator at your hospital. And all the event times, what time exactly what happened has to be recorded very clearly, and all intervals also have to be mentioned. Starting from time of collapse, that is time of event when it started, till time of abandonment of resuscitation efforts. All the events has to be very categorically, crisply mentioned. Outcome variables, whether survived, not survived, immediate, in case of survival, immediate return of spontaneous circulation, short term, long term, longevity, quality of life, everything has to be mentioned. It can be immediately after the event or it can be later on. Hospital variables. As I told you, this is for academic interest only. It is required for inter-hospital comparisons. Thank you.